presentation from, thank you, from Professor Papia Chaudhary. I will just unmute her. Let me.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yeah, Papia. Yes.
Okay, so
maybe you give your brief introduction yourself and then start with the presentation. Okay.
Yeah. I have to give my introduction. Yeah.
Yeah. Because there are true. Participants from not only from India, but they are from outside.
Yeah,
also.
Yeah. I am Papia Chaudhary. I am a faculty in JP Institute of Information Technology. It is situated in Noida. It is very adjacent to Delhi. It is only 6 kilometers here, Delhi is. And exactly it is under UP, Uttar Pradesh. So our institute is mainly it's an engineering institute, but since it is a university, we have many courses also, which are in the normal science, like mathematics. We have master degree courses, but mainly we have a degree course in engineering, computer science, information technology, electronics, biotechnology. And we have some normal master's course like mathematics, physics, these are there. We have some integrated program also. We have MBA also. So it's a very good institute. So you can see that this is one sided view of my institute, though it is a very wrong time. But still, due to this lockdown, our pollution level is very low. And that's why the beauty of the Delhi NCR, you can see from this side also. Okay, so can I start my talk?
Yes, sure, Papia. Yes.
Okay, so my talk is on a specific type of material which is known as quantum dots. So I'll discuss about the applicability of quantum dots in some freeze state, means in the solid matrix phase, for the application for different biomedical industry. Mainly its optical phenomena are used for the industry. So let us discuss a little bit about the quantum dots. What is that? How it can be used? What type of material it is? Now the quantum dots are mainly nano-sized material. Its usual dimension is from 2 to 20 nanometer. So it is a little bit smaller than the normal nanomaterial. This type of material mainly are in the area, you can find that they are the semiconductor in nature. The beauty of quantum dot, its characteristics comes due to its quantum confinement. Actually, if you see this figure, you can see that in the left-hand side part, I have described the band gap in the case of molecule. In the molecule, if you have, or in the atom, you have the band gap are too much high between the homo and lumo. But if you move towards quantum dot, the band gap will be a little bit slower. If you move towards right again, normal nanoparticles, the band gap again will be slower than that or smaller than that. But if you move to normal bulk semiconductor, the band gap will be too much low. Now the band gap plays here a big role for the this quantum dot material. Now within this band gap area, what happens in the quantum dot type of material, a quantum confinement appears. And due to this quantum confinement, a discreteness in the energy level, in the of the electronic energy level, appears in this type of material. And due to in this quantum confined region, what happens? The size of the material, that means in this type of material, that means a quantum dot, you can control the size. And if you can control the size of this material, that appears as different colors from the material. You can vary the size of this material in this quantum confined region, and due to that, the discreteness in the energy level appears. And due to that discreteness of the energy level, what gives it gives some beautiful optical properties, mainly in the form of color. So I show that phenomena now. A little bit discuss about that dimension of the material again. If you see it, in normal semiconductor, what we know, we have two types of band. One is the valence band, and another one is the mainly conduction band. In the normal criteria is that the valence band should be filled with the electrons and the conduction band should be vacant. Now in the norm, what will happen if we give some energy to the electron? So the tendency of the electron will be to move from this valence band by overcoming the band gap to move to the conduction band. So what will happen when an electron will reach to the semiconductor material in the conduction band, and it will leave behind a deficiency of electron, which we know that this is the hole. So an electron will rise to the conduction band, leaving behind a hole in the valence band. This action, what will happen? Then the electron and the hole combination in this case, in the electron in the conduction band and the hole in the valence band, will known as a exciton in the case of semiconductor in some cases. And this exciton means the electron cannot overcome this electrostatic pull, and they are the electron and hole will always be inside that electrostatic pull. Now if that happens, the normal average distance between the electron and hole in the exciton is known as the excited Bohr radius. Now for the quantum dot, when the size of this semiconductor falls below the dimension of this Bohr radius, then that specific semiconductor will be known as quantum dot. Otherwise, it will be a normal semiconductor, or it will be nanomaterial. So all nanomaterials are not quantum dot. So the nanometer will become quantum dot only when the dimension is less than that of the Bohr radius. So what is special about this quantum dot? Now, since it is quantum dot, the excitons are confined in a smaller space within that Bohr radius. And that's why what will happen, the quantum dot will feel in within that region that they are trapped by a infinite potential wheel. Okay? And when they are trapped in an infinite potential wheel, their energies will become discrete, because from the basic quantum mechanics, we know that if a particle having mass is trapped in an infinite potential wheel, the energy level of that particle is discrete. So this situation leads a discreteness, or you can say the quantization of the energy for that quantum dot, and they have a discrete energy level. And this is the reason that the quantum dots are known as artificial atoms. Now, since they have discrete energy level, so they will move from one energy level to another energy level. So small, very small change in the size of the quantum dot, they will give a separate energy level, separate band gap. That means they can be tuned finely to a specific desired energy level. If they can tune finely, then what will happen? Depending on that energy gap, they will give us different colors. So by controlling the size of quantum dot, what we can do, one can tune to emit any color of light. The beauty is that the quantum dot, when it will emit the color of light, mainly it appears in the visible region. That means with our bare eye also, we can view that light. Okay, the band gap of the quantum dots, they will give directly related to the size, and that's why it is directly related to the color also. The energy band gap here, it is inversely proportional to the size of the quantum dot. You can see in this figure that if the band gap is too much big, then the size of the quantum dot is small. And since band gap is too much big, the energy difference is big, so the frequency required to make the transition from the lower energy level to higher energy level will be more. Since the frequency is high, the color will be towards blue. And in the case of if the size is big, then the band gap will be less. If the band gap is less, then less energy is required. Less energy means higher wavelength. That means the color is red. So we can vary the energy band gap by changing the size. And if we can change the size, what will happen? When the electron will move from lower energy level to the higher energy level to any of the quantum dots. Suppose I have three quantum dots having three colors here, red, green, and blue. The electron goes to the conduction level, and when, since the energy level, according to the law of energy level, higher energy level is not a stable state, so electron has to come down. When the electron will come down, for the right hand side, the figure, it will emit blue color, and for the left hand side, it will emit red color. So in this way, we can get some beautiful colors of the quantum dot. In the lower figure, I have shown you some beautiful colors which the quantum dots used to emit. So that is the beauty of quantum dot, different colors. Now in market, we have different types of quantum dots. But I want to mention you here that the research in this quantum dot is not very old. It is very new. Around 1980s, it has started. And we are only very 30 years old, the studies. So there are very few work with these quantum dots, because there are many properties, many characteristics, many applications still they are unknown about the quantum dots. But still there are lots of work are going on in this quantum dots also. Now again, about the types of the quantum dots. What are the types they are available in the area of quantum dots? They are quote type of quantum dots. Some are quote shell type of quantum dots, and some are alloyed type of quantum dots. Now, quote type of quantum dots, they have the diameter from 2 to 6 nanometer. Examples are CdT, cadmium telenide, CdHg, CdSc. There are many semiconductor materials in the market which are available. They can create this size. Now, next in this category is core shell type of quantum dot. They have little bit big diameter because on the core type of quantum dots, for the shell, we are giving a coating of shell of quantum dots. So their dimension will be a little bit more, that is 6 to 10 nanometer. And next we have alloyed type of quantum dot. The alloyed type of quantum dot, again, it is same as the core type of quantum dot, its characteristic, but it is a mixture of some quantum dots. So core type, you can say that it is pure type of quantum dot, and alloyed type, it is a mixture of quantum dots. Now, depending on the activities or the application areas, one of the major drawback of the quantum dots are, since they are inorganic in nature, because they are semiconductor, mainly inorganic in nature, so they are very much toxic. So this table shows that what are the level of toxicity of different types of quantum dots. Okay. Now the next is, since quantum dot can give a very good optical signal to us, the quantum dots are applicable in today's imaging industry. Too much application is there in the today's imaging industry, because we have lots of drawback in today's imaging industry. Mainly all of you know that in the imaging industry, for the biomedical imaging, we generally use some fluorescence dyes. But fluorescent, and for imaging, we need a specific signal from a specific part of the body, you can say. But what are the drawbacks of mainly the organic fluorophore we use in the market? That is mainly one of the example is rhodamine dye. Now the problem of rhodamine dye is that its absorption spectra is very much sharp. In this figure, you can see that. And its emission spectra is not very sharp. It has a symmetrical view, so it is not very sharp. But what is our requirement? The absorption should be wide and the emission should be very sharp. Because if the emission is very sharp, then specific color we can get. And from that specific color, high intense color, we can get a proper information. But the problem with the organic fluorophore is that they have wide emission, but sharp absorption. But instead of that, quantum dots, they have broader absorption and a narrow, and you can say that more sharply defined emission peak. Due to this unique property, a single light source can be used to excite a multicolor quantum dot simultaneously without any signal overlap. So if we use for the imaging, instead of using the normal fluorescence dye, if we replace it by the quantum dot, then they can give very good signal. Okay. There are many applications of quantum dot, not only in the bio industry, but there are other industry also. One of the main application is non-linear active material. They are very much in demand in today's industry because we can use it for the computation purpose also. They can be used as a light emitting diode, as a laser. They can use as quantum computation. They can use as the solar cell also. But our point of interest is that in the medical industry, they are used for detecting different hazardous materials. And they are using for the imaging of different disease cell like cancer, like tumor. Also, they are used as a drug carrier and as a drug also, because nowadays quantum dots are using as a drug to burn the or to damage the cancer cell also. But still, there are some problem with the quantum dot. One problem is it is very much toxic. Since it is semiconductor in nature, so it is not soluble in water and it is not biodegradable also. So to solve this problem, we have tried with, many people are trying with different quantum dots. In present work, I'll discuss about a single quantum dot, that is cadmium telenide, that is CTDE quantum dot. Sometimes it is a core type of quantum dot, and sometimes it is a core shell type of quantum dot also. Like other quantum dot, it is not water soluble. So it is a water insoluble material. If a material is water insoluble, for the bio application, it is not of our use. And again, since it is made of cadmium, and cadmium is very hazardous material for the environment also. But and the otherwise, the CdT quantum dot, it has a very good optical property. It has a very high quantum yield. And it has full width, half maximum of 28 nanometer. So somehow we think that we have to use this optical property for the imaging purpose, for the medical purpose. So for that, what is the other options to use this material? But since it is not water soluble and it is toxic, I cannot use it directly for the body. So the problem, the solution of the problem came as the existence of capping agent. There are many capping agents in the market, and mostly all the capping agents are organic in nature.
ये देख लीजिए, हिंदी होगी अच्छी, लेकिन भाषा तो ठीक नहीं पड़ेगी. भेज दिया मैंने आपको.
Okay, I am audible to you now, all? Yes. Okay. Poonam, I am audible to you?
Yes, very
well. Okay. So in presence of capping agent, what are the beauty of this capping agent? That if you put capping agent on this quantum dot, they will become soluble to water. And they will become stable also. And the hazardous nature can diminish that hazardous nature also, because we are giving some coating on this molecule. Okay. So instead of this capping agent, there are many capping agents are available in the market. There are some peptides, there are some antibodies, there are some polymers, there are some surfactants also. So they are used as the coating agent. What happens actually, the structure, if you put this capping agent with this quantum dots, they will create a micelle like structure exactly. Okay. And when that create that structure, the quantum dot will give its totally property as it is. So the capping agent normally don't react with the quantum dots, because capping agents are organic in nature and quantum dots are inorganic in nature. So we have started our work with the concept of CDT. What we did, because CDT are available in the market also, you can buy CDT, also you can synthesize CDT. There are many techniques to synthesize this CDT quantum dots. But in the industry or in our research area, there is no available structure of CDT. So what we have done, first we have optimized the structure, tried to optimize different configuration of CDT. So you can see that in this figure, I have optimized different structure. In that case, I have used the combination as 1:9, that means 1:9. So if you there are many other also you can consider, but till 9 in this work I have described for you. I have optimized this structure, and all are optimized with DFT, with the DFT model. After the optimization, what we did, we have calculated the computed absorption spectra, mainly visible absorption spectra. So in this left hand side, you can see that the lower part, I have plotted the visible absorption spectra, and I have plotted the experimental absorption spectra also with my quantum dot, which I have synthesized. Also, you can buy the quantum dots in Sigma Allergy, it is quietly available. So if you get it, and if you dissolve it in some, since it is not dissolvable in water, you can dissolve it in any hydrocarbon solvent, it will be easily dissolvable. Then if you take the absorption, so it was observed that experimentally it is giving a absorption at 488 nanometer. And out of this all optimized structure, only it is for near about matching with the CDT6 cluster size. Okay, so then we have derived the size of this quantum dot. What is the size theoretically of this quantum dot? So we have derived the size of this quantum dot, first theoretically, and second from the experimental data. So lower is the formula is given in to calculate it from the experimental data. So we have calculated the size of the quantum dot, and we observed that theoretically, the size is around 8.3 nanometer, but experimentally, the size is coming around 10.2 nanometer. Also, the wavelength is little bit shifting towards the reddish side. That means towards the red side. So the question came in mind that maybe there are some agglomeration, because quantum dot, you are making it a very small size of structure and you are putting it in the solution. So there is high chance that all the quantum dot will come together and they will make an agglomerated solution, or they will make a big cluster like structure. So this point came to our mind, because the size experimentally we are getting and the theoretically we are getting, they are a little bit different. They are not exactly same. So then what we did, we have calculated its electronic property also. We have calculated the band gap of this material to check it. Theoretically, we have obtained the band gap, and we obtained that the band gap came as 8.85 electron volt. Experimentally, it came at 8.63 electron volt. Little bit changes there. So still, these two results are very much nearby. We thought that maybe experimentally, the quantum dot we are making, it is nearby to this structure, CDT6. So in the further calculation also, we considered that CDT6 is the most stable structure and which is experimentally matching with the data. So let us consider this structure as the as our stable structure and move with this structure. So next, we have tried with different capping agents. Now, there are different capping agents available in the market. Our one of the problem was we have to stop by anyhow the agglomeration of the quantum dot. So capping agent is a very good example which can stop the agglomeration. So there are many capping agents are available. So I have given you some name like PVA, some TGA, L-cysteine, L-glutathione. There are many quantum dots capping agent are available in the market. And the proceeding they are making is very simple. There is nothing hard and fast chemical way to make this quantum dot with this capping agent. So we have used a very simple method. What is the method? We have used in this case polymer, because somehow we have to make the quantum dot in the solid phase. So we have used PVA as the polymer. We mixed it with water, then we have used magnetic stirrer, and then we have added CDT in that. Okay, and after that making it, we keep it on the petri dish. I think someone is disturbing on the slide. Lighting something on the slide. Some writing is coming on the slide.
You do it again. Just unshare the screen and then share it again. That is the only way.
Okay. Let us check in the next slide. It is coming or not? Yeah, it is coming.
It will not come. Yeah. Just unshare and share. Yeah. That is the only way.
Okay. Okay. Now, and I think I can text erase it. I can erase it.
If it is there. Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Actually, I am not very familiar with this
Zoom,
Zoom system.
We all are not familiar with this.
From the last 20 days, I am getting familiar with this.
Yeah, we all.
Okay, so yes, I know that all the Indians are now all the teachers, Indian teachers, basically they are. So we have added this quantum dot in this solution and keep it for 10 hours in a higher temperature, and ultimately we got a film-like structure. The thickness we have measured, it was around 70 micrometer. Then we have went for the XRD analysis. Now in the XRD analysis, first we have to check that if, since we have put the quantum dot in the PVA film, so is there any complex formation or is there any interaction between the polymer and the quantum dot? First we have to check that. So we went for the XRD. We got that the PVA here in the right hand side figure A is the XRD for the PVA, and with CDTA we got two extra peak in CDTA PVA combination, and both the peaks are due to 111 and 220 plane. We have used the device shader formula, and from that we got the size of the quantum dot. It came as 5.81 nanometer. That means inside the PVA matrix, inside the PVA, what happens, that agglomeration formation of quantum dot, it becomes invisible. The agglomeration is becoming less and less because it is in the solid phase. And that's why the size is decreasing of that quantum dot. So this was one study from the XRD analysis. Then we went for the UV visible analysis, same type of analysis. And we have observed that in presence of PVA, there is no extra peak is coming. That means PVA is not at all interacting with the quantum dot. Again, by using the absorption study, you see that in this case, in the right-hand side figure, the pure PVA, it is giving only the black color, and the red one is PVA plus CDT. So what we have done, we have calculated the size, and we got that the size in the solid phase, it came as 6.2 nanometer. So that means it is less than the quantum dot in the solution phase, where PVA is not giving any extra new peak in presence of quantum dot. So the estimated size of the quantum dot, which was measured 8.3 nanometer in the solution phase, we got that size is 6.2 nanometer in the solid phase. We have done the luminescence spectra also. And from the luminescence spectra also, we have tried to get the size calculation. And PVA also, we got that in the lumination study, PVA is not showing any peak in the luminescence, where quantum dot in presence of PVA, it is showing the same peak which it is showing in case of solution phase. The only difference is that the peak is little bit broadened, okay? And the peak is little bit blue shifted, okay? The blue shift means that the agglomeration is very less in in presence of PVA, and the size is becoming a little bit small also. And so the smaller size we get in case of solid phase from the luminescence, that also this is the formula which we have used to get the size of the polymer, PVA and CTD combination in the matrix. We got the size around 6 nanometer. Then again, as we have done it for the previous case, we have done the studies, the electronic property, and from the electronic property, what we got in the solid phase, we got that the band gap is more in the solid phase. That is, the band gap we got, it is 9.5 electron volt in the solid matrix form. Whereas in the solution phase, the band gap was a little bit lower, that means slower. So from that we can conclude that since the band gap is higher, that means inside the polymer matrix the quantum dot is not agglomerating. That is the good observations or the best observation in the solid phase. So but till now what we got, the result we got that it is less agglomeration in the quantum dot and the smaller particle size is observed in the solid phase matrix. So with this we have done some calculation for the optical analysis with some disease cells, with the help of some healthy cells also. Now, what we know, this is the figure, this is the comparison between the normal cell and the cancer cell. You can see that the cancer cell, their structure is changed from the normal cell. Normally, they have a variable shaped nuclei, whereas in normal cell, the nuclear shape little bit is fixed. For the cancerous cell, we have many divided cells, disorganized arrangement, variation in size, and they have a loss in normal feature of the cell. It observed in case of cancer cell. So what we have done, we have used the quantum dot for the imaging of this cancerous cell. So for that, one point I have to mention that roughly 9.6 million people die from cancer in every year. This is a report from the ACS report. Okay. And if we can diagnose the cancer disease earlier, and if we can give the basic treatment at the earlier time, then we can save the life. Now, in normal technique, how to view the cancerous cell, again, normal fluorescence dyes are used. But if we give quantum dot, with the help of quantum dot, we can identify the cancerous cell very early stage, or suppose I have a very less number of cancerous cell also. So the quantum dot it is using as a target. So with this, we can get the image very properly. Because the drawback of the normal organic dyes are they are also toxic. They have low stability and very low quantum yield. So in the left hand side figure, you can see that if you use normal dyes, you will not get any color. So what we did, what is our motivation? So we want to put the quantum dots inside the cancerous cell. Okay. Now the beauty of quantum dot is that not all. If we have the capped quantum dot with the organic capping, then they will not affect the healthy cell also. But if you have no capping, then they can affect the healthy cell. So this is the comparison figure with the quantum dot. If you have quantum dot on the upper hand, then quantum dot will go inside, or they will make a complex with the cancerous cell. And if you illuminate from the upper part, then easily, since quantum dot will emit color, you can view that quantum dot and you can identify the cancerous cell. So in the right hand side figure, I have shown you that thing. There is a mice who has cancer. So with the help of quantum dot from the outer side also, since it is emitting visible light from the outer side also, you can view that color of the quantum dot. So what we have done, we have used two types of cell. One was human breast cancer cell, it is known as MCF7, and we have also used the healthy cell. So this is the protocol for using the cancerous cell before doing the quantum dot treatment at different concentration. We have tried it. And for that, what we have done, there are some technique that you have to give some different concentration of the cell, quantum dot, to the cell, and you have to check the cell viability. If the cell viability is less than 80%, then beyond that concentration, you cannot take. So what we have used, we have checked that the cell viability is higher for the concentration of 0.5 picogram per microliter, 1 and 5 picogram per microliter. Beyond that, the cell viability is decreasing, so we have not considered the higher concentration of quantum dot. Then what we have used, we have compared the two cells. One is for the healthy cell, another one is for the breast cancer cell. Healthy cell is, we have used it for the rat cardiac cell. That, so healthy cell was H9C2 and the cancerous cell was MCF7. And we have applied the quantum dot in both the cells. And what we got, that the result we got that at 0.5, 1 and 5 picogram per microliter, the healthy cell cell viability is intact. It is more than 80%. That means it is not affecting the healthy cell, but it is affecting the cancerous cell. You can see that at 5, it is affecting the cancerous cell and the cancerous cell is dying. Okay, and as well as it can, we have to check that it is giving some optical signal from that or not. So for that, what we have done, we have viewed the cancerous cell. Now in this figure, in the control cell, you can see that we have not applied any quantum dot. The cancerous cell are viewing like the flower-like structure, round flower-like structure, because they have no fixed dimension of the nucleus and the cell. Now we have added the quantum dots. If after adding the quantum dots, you can see that in the next figure, for the 1 picogram per microliter, that flower-like structure are disappearing. For 5 picogram per microliter, again it is more disappearing. But at 50 picogram per microliter, the cells are damaging. That means the cells are dying. So this was first study. And then we have obtained the optical signal. And from that optical signal, what we got, if we have untreated cancerous cell, you can see that the green color are with the normal dyes. And in green color, we have added the quantum dots in the cell. You can see that after 6 hours, it is showing a bright light from the cancerous cell. After 24 hours also, it is showing the bright light. But after 48 hours, some cells are dying. That means we can say that if we apply quantum dot on the cancerous cell also, till 24 hours after applying the quantum dot, you can view the quantum dots very well in the cancerous cell also. And also, it can damage the cancerous cell also with its toxicity. So as a whole, in conclusion, we can say that the non-existence of interaction is possible in case of polymer capping quantum dots. So we can use it for very many medical applications. The agglomeration is prevented in the polymer matrix medium. Larger band gap again validates that data. And we have applied successfully in detecting different disease cells. But one problem generally it came in our case that we have also got the cell death also. So we are thinking that in this phase, CDT is not very applicable. We have to modify the structure a little bit more. That means we have to apply, so we have to try with some other capping reagent also. And so in the solid form also, it may be considered as the most promising candidate for the application based on the optical signal for the our biomedical industry. So these are some recent publication in this area. I have done some work. I have started some work just a few years back. And these are my collaborators, my students. Some of them are already placed, some of them are abroad. And my collaborators is from, one of them is from JNCSR Bangalore. And the first synthesis part, I used to take help from Amrita. She's in BITS Goa. Abhishek is now PDF in Jerusalem. So they always, we combine in a group, we do our work. So thank you very much. I think I have finished my talk, Dr. Professor Poonam.
Okay, I was mute. That was the issue. Okay, sorry. Is there any questions? I was just looking for questions. It is very nice presentation. Nice presentation, nice talk. Very informative. Just comments. So there is, I think, no question. If there is no question, we can proceed.